So what are my thoughts on Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2? Ladies, it's Cyberland coming back to you with another Marvel Cinematic review. This time we're moving from Guardians of the Galaxy on to Volume 2. So Volume 2, it picks up probably not too long after the first one. And this film more so focuses on Star-Lord more than any of the other characters, and the reason why is because we start to find out about his backstory and why, for example, he was able to hold the Power Stone in the first film and not completely be eradicated by it. That's one thing that we learn. We also learn a little more about the relationship between Gamora and Nebula. We also learn more about the relationship with them. Also, Thanos in regards to his mindset with the two girls and why they act the way they do to some extent. So we get to see that. We also get to see more of the understanding of the group in general. Also, we have Mantis is a new character that comes in. Not to necessarily join the group, but she's pressed. She makes her appearance. Same thing, Yondu has a bigger part to play in this one as opposed to the first one, which I didn't mention, but he also played a great role in the first film. But he has a bigger role in this film. Also, Sylvester Stallone makes a cameo too, along with Michelle Yao, and Ving Rhames. They make a cameo too, so that's pretty cool to see them. And this film just kind of gives a... It's more of a family vibe to it. It's not as comedic as the first one, even though I like it just as much as the first one. I just noticed that the what they're going for, I totally get it, because we're trying to go into the whole thing about Star-Lord's background and who he's related to and why. And of course, his father happens to be Kurt Russell. I think his name is... I'm trying to remember all these characters' names. Ego. So we get to see stuff about him. And of course, we start to see some... If it hasn't already been established, it's starting to show that Gamora and Star-Lord are starting to develop a relationship, a couple relationship. The other thing is, Drax is kind of becoming less hardened, I would say, in this film as opposed to the other one. You can see that to his own degree, how he tries to liven up a little bit. The other thing too is Baby Groot, Baby Groot is Baby Groot is probably the funniest part of the second film, about how he just interacts with everybody. It's pretty cute and pretty cool. The other thing is Rocket. We start to see that Rocket does have, he more so opens up too. He more so opens up to the shell that he had in the first film. He's becoming more outspoken and more geared towards trying to find his place, but also be able to work with the group as well. I think too, with this film, is the members start to realize that they do need each other. They do better with each other than splitting off from each other. That's the other thing. And we also see some elements of Star Lord that in his interaction with Ego or Ego that you know when those realizations come, you're kind of like, whoa, like really? It's kind of like even when I was in the theater, I watched it with my kids. I was just kind of like, I didn't see that. I didn't see that part coming, and it's just like that. Wow, that's messed up. So there's a lot of that too. Whereas the first film, you saw all the darkness right up front. This film was kind of like an onion. It was peeling back the layers of how, like, the way the film starts, the way it ends. It starts out lighthearted, and as you keep getting further into the story, it gets darker and darker and darker and darker. Whereas the first film was already dark and light mixed in at the same time, but it was mostly back and forth. This film, it starts out light, and it just gets further darker. And then at the end of it, it kind of opens back up to a light, lighthearted to an extent. Whereas it started out, it was lighthearted, and then it just got really dark and morbid. So that's the one thing I noticed about this film too. My rating for it, I would give it 4.5 out of 5. The only reason I wouldn't give it a 5 is I think the story was good, but I just think the first story was a lot better. I think Guardians 2 was kind of like, it had a lot to have to fight with, I guess per se, with where to go with the story. I kind of feel like Ego probably should have been not introduced in this film just yet. I think they should have had somebody else, but kind of have him kind of start making his way into the film. I think he would have been better used, like, to have a cameo or kind of something in the film, but not fully yet. And then to have him more so be, because he's a very prominent character in the comics. I just felt like maybe they could have used him a little better. I'd say that's probably it. Otherwise, the film was good. There wasn't anything I didn't like, per se. I mean, Drax was a little annoying this time around, like, his comedy part of it. But I get what they're trying to do. I was just like, eh, shut up, dude. So, that was that. And then, as far as entertainment, it's the same as the first one. It wasn't as funny as the first one. And when it came to having a piece of something for everybody, I think it kind of did that. I still think it had that element where it gave something to everybody, whether you're a kid or parents or just adults or a couple, it kind of still encompassed all that. So, you know, it was one of those films. So, if you enjoyed the first one, definitely watch the second one. If you're trying to get the whole understanding of the Infinity Saga, then yes, I suggest, you know, yeah, you're going to need to watch this one too, because there's just little elements in here that are important for the Infinity Saga as a general. And that's the thing about, as I continue to go through these films, some films are more important than others, but every film has something that makes it important to the whole story of the Infinity Saga. So with that being said, I think we will be jumping on to Avengers Age of Ultron next. That's the next one in the chronological order. So, that being said, take care.